In this video, we will focus on the details of the README and interpretation sheets. We will begin with the README sheet. The text box on the left-hand side of the sheet provides a brief overview of economic evaluation concepts. It then outlines an important measure used under the cost-effectiveness analysis framework in economic evaluations, the incremental cost-effectiveness ratio, or ICER. The text box on the right-hand side of the sheet outlines how this tool has been designed to help users perform economic evaluation concepts using the CEA framework. As we saw briefly in the last video, the CEA data entry sheet is relatively simple, and the actual computation of the ICER is straightforward. The challenge in performing a cost-effectiveness analysis is in getting the details right so that the ICER is interpretable and useful. Thus, the CEA plan sheet is designed to help users think through these details. It does this by helping teams, which often include policymakers, data analysts, and programmers, have useful discussions and negotiations about how they want to perform the CEA. The two most important factors to consider for a successful CEA are to 1, carefully identify the details of the analysis, and 2, obtain reasonable estimates for the appropriate cost and health outcomes, such that the ICER can provide useful and interpretable information. As we will see shortly, only 2 main items in the CEA plan sheet overlap with the CEA data entry sheet: item 5, costs, and item 6, measurable health outcomes. All other items are prompts within the CEA plan are designed to help clarify the meaning of these two measures. Now let's move on to discuss the interpretation sheet. In order to interpret the incremental cost-effectiveness ratio, or ICER, we must consider its component parts: the numerator, the denominator, and the direction in which we want the health outcome to go. Let's first consider the numerator. This is the net cost, and it's defined as the cost with the intervention minus the cost without the intervention. It can take on 3 possible signs. The net cost can be positive, meaning that the intervention resulted in increased costs. Or the net cost can be negative, meaning that the intervention resulted in decreased costs. Lastly, the net cost can be indistinguishable from 0, meaning that the intervention had no discernible effect on cost. Now let's consider the denominator. This is the net outcome, and it's defined as outcomes with the intervention minus outcomes without the intervention. Just as with the numerator, it too can take on 3 possible signs. The net outcome can be positive, meaning that the intervention resulted in increased outcomes. Or the net outcome can be negative, meaning that the intervention resulted in decreased outcomes. And lastly, the net outcome can be indistinguishable from 0, meaning that the intervention had no discernible effect on outcomes. Finally, we must consider the direction of the outcome. Do we want to minimize or maximize the health outcome? There are only 2 possible cases for this one. If the health outcome is bad, then we will want to minimize it. However, if the health outcome is good, then we'll want to maximize it. In total, there are 18 unique combinations of the cases given above. This sheet outlines each combination and discusses how to interpret the results. We won't spend any time on this now, but we will use this sheet when we interpret the ICER from the case study in a later video. We'll pause here for now, and in the next video, we will discuss the case study.